Mathieu Eugene delivers a moving speech during Martin Luther King Day at Erasmus High School in Brooklyn, New York, on Monday, January 16, 2012. He also awards students and faculty members for their achievements. We invite you to watch and listen carefully.
Thank you very much. With all our staff, thank you very, very much. I know that I have time to mention the names, but it is very important. Because there is nothing that I can do. There's nothing that any elected official can do without the support of the staff. Today we are here to celebrate the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. It is fitting to do that. It is very important to take a moment pause to reflect on the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. I don't let you know anything about Dr. Martin Luther King. There's nothing that I can teach. But one thing I can say, the sacrifices of Dr. Martin Luther King change the United States of America. Change us the world. And this Dr. Martin Luther King, an advocate, a strong leader, a fighter for civil rights, for equal opportunity, for liberty and justice, because of his sacrifices, United States of America is a better country. Dr. Martin Luther King, because of his sacrifices, barriers have been removed, opportunities have been created. You and I, we are enjoying opportunities and privileges that Dr. Martin Luther King said didn't have when he was there. He couldn't go and change the white deserved the white people. He couldn't. He couldn't be sitting in the box like anybody, you know that. He couldn't. He had a dream. And it is because of his dream that all of us, we are here today in this auditorium. It is because of his dream that he, Matthew Eugene, a young boy, born in Haiti and raised in Haiti, could become a city councilmember in this city of New York. It is because of Matthew Eugene. And it is also because of my intervention that we can have now in the United States of America the first black president by the time. When I look at the audience, I see many people, professionals, each one of us, we have accomplished so much. And we have so much to be proud of. But we couldn't be who we are now without the sacrifices of Martin Luther King. You know, Martin Luther King changed the path of the world. You know, Martin Luther King liberated his country because of the principle of non-violence of Martin Luther King. And let me tell you, Martin Luther King believed in education. He was fighting, and that's the reason that the city councilmember of the city of New York represented this issue. I do everything that I can do to support the school and to ensure that the schools have the proper resources to provide a good and the best education for our children. That's where the problem for that Christian ceremony. That's where the problem proud soul for the graduation of the people. But it's so tired, it's so hard to say. So, yes, sir, it's so hard. A beautiful place like that, it is not comfortable. It is not suitable for people to stay for 4 or 5 hours in the summertime. When I used to come to the celebration, to the ceremony of graduation, and I used to see the power of the children like that, because it is so hard inside. You know what I did? I did 1 million to the Rouse, but it's not the air conditioning. We have to take a commitment, each one of us, to do something to better the community where we are living. We have to take a commitment to improve the quality of life, not only of our loved ones, but also the quality of life of people who are living in the area where we are living, the people who are in our community. One of the things that I want to ask young people, please listen to this subject. I'm asking you to do everything that you can to prevent violence in the community. Because violence is destroying our community. Violence is eliminating so many young people who could be the leaders of tomorrow. 2 years ago, a young boy was stabbed right there on Franklin Avenue and stabbed a million ladies. Was stabbed. Some violence. I mean, young people, even they die because of violence. If you and us can work together, we can save so many lives. You know, when there's violence, you don't know who the next one is going to be. You don't know. And people who have been victims of violence, some of them, they are your friends. Let us work together as a community to ensure that we have a safer community. Because you are the leaders of tomorrow, we wish you every man that we can protect you. And you also, you should be part of God. May God bless you. May God bless everybody in your family. And thank you for coming here.